welcome to the class. Today I am going to discuss about locus. I will upload two videos for locus. One is for the basic concept and basic problems in locus, and another one is for object to purpose, the mains and MCQ level. Okay. First, locus. What is meant by locus? It is one of the important topic. Actually, locus is very one of the important topic. Locus means, and at the same time, it is very easy. Locus means path or find an equation by using given condition. So simply we can say locus means a path or finding an to find an equation by using the given condition. That's the matter for locus. So how the given conditions will be? So before going to enter into the topic locus, we have to know some points which is related to locus. The first one, basic concept in the geometry also. Suppose this is coordinate axis, x-axis and y-axis. Here is a point P, x, y. Here is a point P on the x, y. So, what does it mean? This is y and this one is x. This total distance is y and this one is x. Now, the point becomes x, y. So, we can write the distance x coordinate, x means x coordinate, I am writing mod x. Maybe the point you may consider here in the second quadrant or in the third quadrant or in the fourth quadrant. So I am writing mod x. What is mod x? You see, this distance is x. So this is also x. This distance can be represented like the perpendicular distance from point to y axis. From point to y axis, the distance is known as x coordinate. Point to y axis is called x coordinate or mod x, and the point to x axis, this is x axis, point to x axis distance is equal to y coordinate, that is mod y is equal to p to x axis. So these two points are important. What is meant by x coordinate? We can call them as abscissa. X coordinate means the perpendicular distance from a point to y axis is called x coordinate, and the y coordinate also can be written as, you can say it as ordinate. The distance, the perpendicular distance from point to x axis is known as ordinate or mod y. Why you are writing mod x and mod y? Maybe the point in the, not only in the first quadrant, you may consider in the second, third, fourth, whatever might be the coordinate, you can take the distance I am taking as modulus. So, x coordinate is the distance from point to y axis, y coordinate is the distance from point to x axis, that is y coordinate. Okay, you remind these two points. Next, this is origin. Everybody knows what is the coordinates of origin? 0, 0. Now, the distance from point to origin, we can call them as OP. OP. The distance from origin to P. And one of the maximum of the problems depends on the distance between the two point formula in the topic locus. It's a very easy topic. Maximum of the problems depends on distance between the two points. When suppose there are two points x1, y1 and x2, y2. What about the formula to find the distance between the two points? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the distance between the two points. Okay? This is, you have to remind it. This is one of the important one. And now, you see, here is the two points. Origin and P. So, what about the distance? Root of x minus 0 whole square. That is x square. And y minus 0 whole square is y square. So, that is OP. So, here are the four points. The first one is x coordinate meant by from point to the y axis. Y coordinate means from point to y axis, x axis. And the distance from origin to the point is OP, that is root of x square plus y square. And one of the familiar formula which we can use in this topic is distance between the two points formula, root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay. Then it's, these formulas are more than enough to find from the basic problems. Okay, now we go through with the locus. locus. What is meant by locus? I already told you, locus is just nothing but path. How the point moves, how the variable point moves. Variable point means, I will give one example. Suppose I am here and I told a student, he has to move in such a way, he is always above, he is always at a distance of 5 meters from me. Okay, I am here only, I am constant, just you feel that I am a constant. I told him he has to run or he has to move in such a way, he is always away from me at a distance of 5 meters. Then what will be his path? You tell me. He is always same distance from me. So he can move in a circle way. That means, you see here. So I am here. So one student moving in such a way, he is always away from me at a distance of from. Suppose he started here. Here the distance is 5 units. And he is running like, he is always away from me at a distance of 5 units only. Now he is 5 and here is the distance is also 5. You may take anywhere. He is moving like the distance is same. So that is his path. That is his path or route. That is nothing but the locus. That is nothing but the locus. That is, here is the constant. Center is fixed. So you see, the locus, the path is just like a circle. So circle definition comes from the locus. That is, from any point, it is a variable point, it is moving point. In the entire topic locus, in each and every problem, we have to write, let P, X, comma, Y be any point on the locus. Let P, X, comma, Y be any point on the locus. On the locus. And this point is moving. This is not a fixed point. This is a variable point. It is moving. In such a way he is moving, it is moving, we have to find that path. That is nothing but the locus. So locus means path, and we have to find the equation of the path by given condition. Okay? That is the locus. You see here the example, he is moving in a circular path. Okay? How to find this equation? Suppose this is a fixed one. As I told you, it is a fixed one. Let us suppose this point is 2, comma 3. And he is moving like at a distance of 5 units. I am assuming this is center C and this is point P. We know that the distance from C to P is 5 units. CP is equal to 5 units. What is meant by CP? Distance between the two points. So distance between the two points is root of. So I am squaring here. CP square is equal to 25. Now, distance between the two points formula, x minus 2 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay? So, after simplifying, you will get x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y. 4 plus 9, 13, that is minus 12 is equal to 0. This is the locus. This is the equation of the locus. Okay? We can call it a circle. So circle, parabola, ellipse, I mean actually there is topics in second year. We will just you find the equation only. Then after the second year, you will have the names. Okay? Now, in the locus, the first step is you have to consider any point on the locus. Locus means path. There is a variable point which is moving in given condition. Some condition. Okay? Directly I am going to problems. Go through with the problems. The first, you see the sentence, first question, you see, find the locus of the point, find the locus of the point. What is, in each and every question, the question will be like, find the locus of the point. That means, there is a point which is moving, we have to find that point equation. Point equation means moving point, so you should be move in such a direction, in such a way, we have to find that equation. So, find the locus of the point, find the locus of the point. Find the locus of the point. Find the locus of the point which is at a distance of 3 units. At a distance of 3 units from minus 1 comma 0. First you have to read the question carefully. Find the locus of the point which is at a distance of 3 units from minus 1 comma 0. So there is a point. Our assumption that point is nothing but Px comma y. This is a locus point. This is a variable point. This is a moving point. That point moves such that it is at a distance of 3 units from this point. I am assuming this point is as A. Now what is given there? Pa is equal to 3. Pa is equal to 3. Now Pa means distance between these two points, that is root of, now you square on both the side, Pa square is equal to 9, x plus 1 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square is equal to 9. So that is the equation of the locus. Okay, next one more question. Find the locus of the point, find the locus of the point whose distance from coordinate axis, coordinate axis is same. Find the locus of the point. There is a point. That point is such that which is equidistant from the coordinate axis. Equidistant from the coordinate axis. First you listen the class, then you can write the notes. Okay, no problem. Whenever you want to write the note, you just pause the video and you can write that one. Okay, first listen the class, the questions. Very simple topic and very basic concept topic, and very, that's the same way it is very important also. Find the locus of the point which is equidistant from coordinate axis. So there is a point. So that point is such that whose distance from coordinate axis, what is meant by coordinate axis? X-axis and y-axis. So that point is equidistant. There is a point Px comma y. That point is equal distance from coordinate axis, x-axis and y-axis. Okay. So what is the equation of that locus? So what is the given coordinate axis? So let Px comma y be any point on the locus. The distance from x-axis is equal to mod y. The distance from y-axis is equal to mod x. Okay. From there is a point, the distance from x-axis is y mod y, the distance from y-axis is mod x. Given in the question, what is the condition? Distances are equal. Now mod x is equal to mod y. We have to consider mod x and mod y only. Don't write x is equal to y, because we don't know where the point lies, either in the first coordinate or first, second, third, fourth. So better you write mod x is equal to mod y. Then squaring on both the sides. So x square is equal to y square, or you can write x square minus y square is equal to 0. This is the locus equation. Okay. Next, I will give one more example. Find the locus of the point. Next question. Find the locus of the point whose distance from x-axis, whose distance from x-axis is 5. Whose distance from x-axis is 5. So there is a point. Our assumption, our point is P, x, comma, y. That point. Whose distance from x-axis, from that point to x-axis distance is 5. So what is the distance from point to x-axis? Mod y. So mod y is equal to 5. That is the locus. That means y square is equal to 25, y square minus 25 is equal to 0. Or you can write y is equal to plus or minus 5. Okay, this is the equation. Next question. Find the locus of the point. It is a common sentence for each and every problem. First you have to know the basic problems. Find the locus of the point whose distance from x-axis is twice the distance from y-axis. Listen the question. Find the locus of the point. There is a point x, px, comma y. That point is such that the distance from that point to x-axis is twice the distance from y-axis. Twice the distance from y-axis. So what is the distance from x-axis? x-axis to the point mod y. And what is the distance from point to y-axis? Mod x. What is the relation between these two in the given question? The distance from x-axis twice. So, x-axis distance is mod y. This is twice, which means the distance is more than that of the distance from point to y-axis. So, this distance is more and this distance is low. So, whenever we have to equate these two, so lower value twice. So, we have to multiply with 2. So, mod y is equal to 2 mod x. Okay. So, y square is equal to 4x square, or y square minus 4x square is equal to 0, or you can write 4x square minus y square is equal to 0. First you know, better you know the, find the equation only. Then what will be this equation, either it is parabola, straight line, curve, whatever might be the curve, you will learn in the next level. First you learned how to find the equation only. Okay, you see the question, find the locus of the point whose distance from x-axis, mod y is twice, this is more than the distance from y-axis. Distance from y-axis means mod x. So we have to compare these two. So it is less value. So we have to multiply with 2. So mod y is equal to 2 mod x. I will give one more example. The distance from x-axis, is equal to, is twice the distance from origin. Find the locus of the point whose distance from x-axis is twice the distance from origin. Okay. The entire matter is in the question itself. Just you have to read carefully and then you can find the solution very easily. By read the question, concentrate. Okay. First, find the locus of the point. What about the point? Px, y is our point. That point is at a distance of x-axis. What is the distance from x-axis, that point? Mod y. Okay? Mod y. And distance from origin. What is the distance from point? Our point is Px, y. Origin is 0, 0. Distance from origin. That is OP. Distance from origin. And the distance from x-axis twice. This is more than that. This distance. So we can multiply 2OP. Distance from x-axis mod y is twice the distance from origin. Distance from origin means OP. So I have told you, what about OP? OP means root of x square plus y square. O means origin. P means x comma y. O means origin. 0, 0. And P is x comma y. The distance between these two points, this one. This is mod y. So, squaring on both the side, you will get y square is equal to 4 of x square plus y square. So, that is 4x square plus 3y square is equal to 0. Okay. Next. Find the locus of the point whose sum of the distances, from coordinate axis, is 5 units. Find the locus of the point. Find the locus of the point, which is that point is such that there is a point Px, y. That point is such that whose sum of the distances from coordinate axis. What is meant by coordinate axis? X-axis and y-axis. The distance from x-axis is mod y and the distance from y-axis is mod x, whose sum mod y plus mod x is equal to 5. This is the equation. So mod x plus mod y is equal to 5. That is the equation of the locus. There is no necessity to square this one. Okay. So, this is the equation of the locus. And in objective examinations, they may ask like, find the area of the locus. Find the area of this locus. Find the area of the locus such that the locus of the point whose sum of the distances from coordinate axis is 5. So, this is the equation. how to find the area of this one? Okay, I will explain. It's a very simple question. So you see, mod x means either plus or minus. Mod y also plus or minus. So there may be four lines. One is you take both plus, plus minus, minus plus, minus minus. X plus y is equal to 5. One more, x minus y is equal to 5. Minus x plus y is equal to 5. Minus x minus y is equal to 5. These are the four lines which represents the locus. Okay. Now what about the graph? X plus y is equal to 5, which means x by 5 plus y by 5 is equal to 1. It is an intercept form of straight line. Of course, if you don't know the concept of intercept form, nothing to worry. Just you listen that one, and whenever the topic straight line completed, then you will do that problem very easily. Okay? The straight line may be like this. X by 5 plus y by 5. This is the line. Here the point is 5 comma 0, and here the point 0 comma 5. And next line may be like this. Another line like this, another line like this. Okay, these are the four lines, and this is the total area. We have to find the area of this formed with these four lines. This is the area of the part which forms with these four lines. We have to find the area of this entire this one. How to find this one? Just you find this area, this triangle area. What about the triangle area? Half base. Base means this is base and this one is height. This is 5. This is also 5. 5 into 5. That is 25 by 2 is the area of this one. This area is also 25 by 2. This area is also 25 by 2. This is also same. So total area is equal to 4 into 25 by 2. That is nothing but 50. Okay. Next one. Find the locus of the point. Now we'll go some lengthy problems. Find the locus of the point which is whose distances ratio, which is, find the locus of the point which is equal distance from minus 1 comma 2, 3 comma 4. Minus 1 comma 2, 3 comma 4. There is a point. Our point is always P, X comma Y. That point is such that there are two points, A and B. A and B are two points. Our point is such that it should be always equidistant. Equidistant. Suppose here is a point P. It should be equal distance. Suppose it moves like, suppose here is the point P. It should be equal. Here is the point, equal distance. It should be equal. Wherever the point P moves, it should be equal distance, such that PA is equal to PV. PA is equal to PV. From diagram, we can draw the locus. This is the point P. It moves like this. This is just nothing but perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular. Suppose there are two points. There are two points, A and B. I have to move in such a way, I should be equidistant from among these students. I have to be equidistant between these students. So what is my path? What is my path? I have to walk in such a way in perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector. Bisector means I should be perpendicular. So these are the two points A and B. Perpendicular means like this. And bisect. Bisect means equal distance. Okay. That should be the path. So, PA is equal to PB. But finding the equation, find the locus of the point which is equidistant from these two points. So, this is the point. Our point is PX, Y. That point P is equidistant. PA is equal to PB. PA is equal to PB. So, if PA is equal to PB, next PA square is equal to PB square. What is P? P is equal to always X, Y. PA distance. P to A distance. Distance between the two points formula. X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square is equal to X minus 3 whole square plus Y minus 4 whole square. Simplifying, x square gets cancelled, y square cancel. Here is 2x and here is minus 6x. It comes to this side, plus 6x. Okay, next, here is minus 4y and here is minus 8y. So that is plus 8y. 1 plus 4, 5. And 4 plus 9 plus 16, 25. Minus 25 is equal to 0. So 2x plus 6x, 8x. This is plus 4y. Minus 20 is equal to 0. So you can cancel, you may cancel 4. That is 2x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0. This is a straight line. You see, this is a straight line. So the path is like this. This is a straight line. For every model, I am saying only one problem only. You better you take different points and you practice it. Okay, next. So the same point I am giving you. Find the locus of the point. Find the locus of the point whose distance from minus 1 comma 2 is twice the distance from 3 comma 4. Find the locus of the point. Always and each and every problem, our point is px comma y. It is a variable point. It is moving. It is moving only. There are two points are given, A and B. I am assuming two points are given, A and B. What is the condition of the question? The distance from P to A is twice. The distance from P to A is twice. Twice means this distance is more than the P to B distance. P to B distance. Which one is lower low distance? It is a lower distance. It is higher. So more than that of PV. So PA is equal to 2PV. So you can write PA square is equal to 4PV square. Squaring on both these sides. Because distance between the two points formula, there is a square root of. So better you square it is, there will be no problem. PA square, x plus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 4 into PB square, PB, x minus 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square. Okay, now, you take all the terms into one side, that is, here is 4x square I am writing, here is 4x square, first I am writing here, 4x square, and here is minus 6x, minus 6 into 4, minus 24x, 9 into 4, 36, plus 4y square, minus 8y, minus 32y, and here is 16 into 4, 64. So this is the expansion of right hand side. And what about the left hand side? Here is x square. When it comes to this side, this is minus x square, minus 2x, minus 1, and here is minus y square plus 4y minus 4 is equal to 0. So y square minus 4, when it comes to that, minus y square plus 4y minus 4 is equal to. You see, the x square terms, here is 4x square and here is minus x square. So it is 3x square. Next, y square term, 4y square minus y square, that is 3y square. Next, x term. So there is an order, we have to follow some order. First we have to write power 2 terms, x square, xy, y square. These are power 2 terms. Here is x square, here is also single term, power is 2, y square. Then we have to write x term, then we have to write y term, and then constant. So this is the order. You better to follow this. So 4x square minus 3x square, 3x square, 3x square, 4y square minus y square, 3y square, minus 24x minus 2x, minus 26x, and minus 32y plus 4y, that is minus 28y. And you see the constant, 36 plus 64, it is 100, 100 minus 5, that is 95 is equal to 0. Concept is very simple, but the problem, sometimes the problem will be lengthy. No, nothing to worry, okay? So this is the condition. The simple thing is, first you have to write the condition. Then it is very easy to solve the equation. Okay, next I will give one more example. Find the locus of the point. Find the locus of the point whose ratio of the distances, whose ratio of distances from -1, 2 and 3, 4 is 2:3. Okay, find the locus of the point. There is a point Px, y. It is our point. There are two points given. What is the condition in the question? The distance from point to these two points, let it be A and B. Distances from Px, y to these two points. So one distance is Pa, other distance is Pb. From P to A, from P to B. How the distances are? The ratio of these distances are in the ratio 2:3. So Pa by Pb is equal to 2/3. So this is the condition. So first we have to read the question carefully and then write the condition. Find the locus of the point such that whose distance ratio of the distances from the two points are in the ratio 2:3. So Pa by Pb is equal to 2/3. Now cross multiply. 3Pa is equal to 2Pb. Squaring on both the side, 9Pa square is equal to 4Pb square. 9 into Pa square. What is meant by Pa square? This is P, this is A. Pa, distance, square. There is no necessity to write square root. So x plus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 4 into Pb square. P to B, x minus 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square. Okay. Now here is 9x square. I am doing directly. It is 9x square and it is 4x square. Okay. That is 5x square. This is 9 into y square. And here is 4y square. So 5y square. Then what about x term? You see here is 2x. 2x into 9. I am writing 18x. And you write here minus 6x. If it is difficult to write like this, just to expand simply, you can have the 2 or 3 more steps, no problem. But the answer should be correct. So here is minus 6x. Minus 6x into 4, minus 24x. When it comes to this side, plus 24x. And y terms, here is minus 4y. Minus 4 into 36, 9, that is minus 36. Minus 8, minus 8 into 4, 32. So it is plus 32y. It is also y. And 1 plus 4, 5. 5 into 9, 45. And 9 plus 16, 25 into 400. That is minus 100 is equal to 0. So then what is the answer? 5x square plus 5y square. 18x plus this one, 42x. This is minus 4y plus minus 55 is equal to 0. So problem will be something. It is lengthy, but the concept is very, very simple. There is a question. We have to read the question carefully and write the condition. When you write the condition, the problem, maximum of the problem will be complete. Just accept the calculation part. Okay. So these are the types of the find the locus by using the distances. Okay. I will give one more example. Maybe there may be some three points. Find the locus of the point P. Find the locus of the point P such that PA square plus PB square is equal to 2PC square, where A is equal to 1, 0, B is equal to 0, -1, C is equal to 1, 1. Directly they given the condition. So it is very easy problem. Our point is Px, y. PA square is equal to PB square is equal to 2PC square. It's a very easy question. Directly they given the condition. PA square. PA square means x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square plus pv square, distance from P to B, x minus 0 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square is equal to 2 into pc square, distance from P to C, x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 1 whole square. So this is x square. I am writing this one x square minus 2x plus 1 plus y square. X square plus y square plus 2y plus 1 is equal to 2x square minus 4x plus 2 plus 2y square minus 4y plus 2. So 2x square, 2y square gets cancelled. And what about x here? This is minus 2x. When it comes to this side, plus 4x. Minus 2x plus 4x. Here is plus 2y. What about there? Plus 4y. 1 plus 1, 2. Here is 2 plus 2, 4. Minus 4 is equal to 0. That is 2x plus 6y minus 2 is equal to 0. You cancel 2. That is x plus 3y minus 1 is equal to 0. So this is the equation. Okay. Next, one more model. For the triangle model, problems based on triangle problems. Okay. See, find the locus of the point P. Find the locus of the point P which makes a right angle, the line joining A minus 1 comma 0, B 2 comma 3. So the line joining AB makes a right angle at P. Find the locus of the point P which makes a right angle, the line joining AB. That means, or you can ask the question in different way. If PAB is a right angle triangle, where angle APB is equal to 90, find the locus of P. The question will be like this. Directly they will even find the locus of P, where angle APB is equal to 90, find the locus of P. Or, in other words, we can give the question in a different way also. The line joining AB makes a right angle at P, then find the locus of P. Okay? Or in other words, the question may be given like AB is a comma B are the ends of hypotenuse of a right angle triangle, then find the locus of the vertex P. So whenever right angle triangle is given, so A, B, this is P, this is our point x comma y, and here is point minus 1 comma 0, 2 comma 3. So we can do this problem in two ways. One is by using distance formula, other one is by using slope formula. I will explain. So first you have to know the condition. What is the question? The line joining AB makes a right angle at P. The line joining AB makes a right angle at P. Then find the locus of P. Okay, or two ends of hypotenuse are 2 comma 3 minus 1 comma 0. Find the locus of the third vertex. Find the locus of the third vertex. This is right angle. So, if this type of problem will given, right angle triangle problem, we can use Pythagoras theorem. From the diagram, we can say PA square plus PB square is equal to AB square by using the diagram. What is PA square? X plus 1 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square plus pb square, x minus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to ab square. Ab square means distance between the two points formula. 2 plus 1 whole square plus 3 minus 0, 3 square. So we have x square minus 2x plus 1 plus y square, x square minus 4x plus 4 plus y square minus 6y plus 9 is equal to 9 plus 9, that is 18. So x square plus x square, 2x square, y square plus y square, 2y square, minus 2x minus 4x minus 6x, and here is minus 6y, and what about the constant? Here is 1, 4, 5, 5 plus 9, 14, 14 minus 18, that is minus 4 is equal to 0. That is x square plus y square minus 3x minus 3y minus 2 is equal to 0. Okay? A right angle triangle is given. We have to find the locus of the third vertex. Third vertex is not given. Two vertices are given. We have to assume that the third vertex is px, y. This is a variable point. Variable point means the point moves like, I will give one diagram also. This is a comma b. Maybe the point here 90 degrees. Maybe the point here, this is 90 degrees. Maybe the point here, here is 90 degrees. Maybe the point here, this is 90 degrees. The point is moving like that. The locus is also a circle. Maybe the point here 90 degrees. Maybe the point here 90 degrees. The locus is a circle, where the ends are nothing but ends of diameter. Okay? You see, this same problem we can do in a different way. It's an easy way. I will explain the model. Not using this Pythagoras theorem. If you know the concept of slope, what is how to find the slope of two points? Slope is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Y2 minus y1 by difference of ordinates by corresponding difference of abscissa. Okay, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Since these two lines are perpendicular, PA is perpendicular to PB. There is no necessary use Pythagoras theorem. Since we know that PA is perpendicular to PB, PA is perpendicular to PB. When two lines are perpendicular, then their product of slopes is equal to minus 1. When the lines are parallel, slopes are equal. When lines are perpendicular, the product of slopes, if one line slope is m1, another line slope is m2, m1, m2 is equal to minus 1. So, slope of PA into slope of PB is equal to minus 1. What is the slope of PA? PA slope is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Y2 minus y1, that is y minus 0 by x minus minus 1, that is plus 1, into slope of PB, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 is equal to minus 1. Okay? So, y of y minus 3 is equal to minus of x plus 1 into x minus 2. So, that is x plus 1 into x minus 2 plus y of y minus 3 is equal to 0. So, x square, this is minus 2x plus x, minus 2, plus y square minus 3y is equal to 0. That is, x square plus y square minus x minus 3y is equal to 0. Maybe sometimes it is a plus or some values may be differ. Nothing to worry. We calculate slowly. Okay? So, this is the easy way to find this type of problem. I will explain one more question. Suppose, find the locus of the point such that it forms a triangle whose area is 2.5 square units with the vertices minus 1, 0 and 2, 3. Find the locus of the point x, y. It forms a triangle with two more points. We know that for a triangle there will be three vertices. One vertex minus 1, 0, other vertex 2, 3, and third vertex they didn't give. It may move. It is a movable point or variable point. It moves. Wherever it moves, but if the area of triangle should be equal to 2.5 square units may be. Suppose the point is here, it may be like that. Of course, here also the area is equal to 2.5 square units. How to find the locus of this P? How the point P moves? So, we have three points. Two are the given points, one is our assumption point. How to find the area? Don't use any formula to find very easily for any triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, whatever it may be. It's a simple one. You write half into, you just follow this one. For a triangle, there will be three points. You write any of the point as first point. Minus 1, 0, first point, second point, third point. You may interchange it, no problem. You may write this one as first point, this is the last point, no problem. First point, second point, third point. And we have to write one more time the first point at the last. Okay? First point, second point, third point. And we have to write the first point, whatever you write in the first point, we have to write it at the end. That is important. Is equal to 2.5. Better you learn this formula. It is very easy. And you can apply for a quadrilateral any. So, area. How to find this area? This is modulus 1. So, you multiply cross multiplication procedure. Minus 3 into 1. Minus 3 minus. So, this should be minus. Plus this value into minus of this one. 2y minus 3x. We have to multiply these two and subtract these two. Arrow mark shape. Plus 0 minus minus of minus y plus y is equal to, these two come to this side, 2 into 2.5, that is 5. So you see minus 3x, 2y plus y, 3y, and it is minus 3 is equal to 5. Okay, from this we can find the answer in two ways. Depends on the options. If it is not options, we can do whatever we like. So first procedure is, just you squaring on both sides, you will get the answer. A plus B plus C formula, or A minus B minus C, whatever it may be. That is, you can write 3 as common. So 9 into, so we have 3 into modulus of minus x plus y minus 1 is equal to 5. So 9 into, squaring on this one, x square plus y square plus 1 minus 2xy minus 2y plus 2x is equal to 25. Squaring on both these sides is 9 and is equal to side value is equal to 25. Squaring a plus b plus c whole square, a square plus b square plus c square, 2ab, 2bc, 2ca. So 2ab you will get minus, 2bc you will get minus, but here is you will get positive value. Okay, so the answer is 9x square plus 9y square minus 18xy minus plus 18x minus 18y, 9 minus 25 minus 16 is equal to 0. So this is the answer. Or you can find in another way. Up to here it is okay. Then the second model is, you can write like this problem. You can write modulus means we have to consider plus or minus. That is minus 3x plus 3y minus 3 is equal to plus or minus 5. That is minus 3x plus 3y minus 3 is equal to 5. Minus 3x plus 3y minus 3 is equal to minus 5. That is minus 3x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 0, and here is minus 3x plus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. You multiply these two, minus 3x plus 3y minus 8 into minus 3x plus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, you can multiply, the same answer you will get. Okay, these are the basic problems in the topic locus. You see the video two or three times, you practice, you may take I am taking only one point, or for each Nebbian model I have taken, I am given only one example. You take two or three examples and you do it practice, then you will have the command on this topic locus. And in the next video, I will post some different questions. Okay? Thank you.